Hey everyone, it's Kinna, how are you? And as promised, more Amnesia, part 3. And we are in the refinery, about to jump down this really lovely, cozy looking hole. Geronimo. You know... My sister keeps asking me where I'm at in the game. Excuse me, and I told her, and she goes, Oh. Well, if you come across a room with a bunch of boxes, you might want to stay on the boxes. So everybody be on the lookout for boxes. She's like this creepy harbinger of doom that just shows up randomly and gives me these very enigmatic tips. He crashed through the surface. The dark Atlantic water smothered him as he struggled to make sense of the situation. Oh. Are these boxes? What? Oh, there's water now. Okay, well, let's go. What? What? What the hell is that? Judging by the music, it's not good. Is there an invisible water monster? Okay, there's a lever. Oh, wow. Are you kidding me? That sounds like a timed door. Okay. All right, so where's Buddy Boy at? I kind of have an idea how much time I have to make it to what? No, idiot. There you go. Oh, bless your heart. You're stuck. Okay. You need... Okay. That looks like the Bible. Yeah. Here you go. Go with God. Alright, we're just... Okay, here we go. Here we go. We just... Oh, Jesus. Oh, no. No. Oh, you get unstuck when it's me in the water, but... Oh, God. Okay. No. Oh, shit. Nope. Okay. Is this thing like a one-hit kill? This seems like a game that would have a one-hit kill. Oh, God. We're going. I swear to Christ, if I miss this door, I'm gonna be so mad. Go fetch. Fetch. Oh, god damn. Oh, okay. Oh, there's the door. Okay, oh, I made it. Woo! Oh my god. I am so tense right now. Okay. The grip I have on my mouse, I'm surprised it hasn't cracked. I guess we just run for it. I don't want to run for it. Oh, God! No. Oh, look, body parts. Here. Will it go after that? Really? You don't want a juicy torso? Can I throw any of these boxes? boxes at him? Oh god, it's a door with a crank. How about... is that an arm or a leg? Yeah, there you go. There you go, buddy. What the hell is this nonsense? Go, go. Oh, Jesus. Oh, oh, oh. Nope, nope. Oh, God. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. A wound is bleeding quite badly. Oh, Jesus. Okay, so not one hit kill, but boy, it does damage. Here. Let me give you a hand. Don't laugh at that. Don't laugh at that. Okay, so he does eat him. I know I just probably wasted time, but I... No! Oh god, oh god. Oh, this isn't... Daniel? Oh, Jesus! Did I do it? Okay, okay. Open! Open! Oh my god. I died. Dead flesh can act as a distraction. Okay, well, first death is out of the way. It's in the bag. Oh my god. Okay. Oh. Wait. Where? Oh, it's up ahead. I think. Okay, we're just... Yep, there he is. Oh! You know, maybe it was divine providence that I died and came... Because I almost missed that. God, this is so nerve-wracking. Here. Can I, like... What is that yellow stuff? Can you injure this thing? I mean, maybe you can't kill it, but can you injure it? I'm gonna throw a box at you. Hold on. Yellow stuff. It looks like I'm... Aw, damn it. We're gonna have to run again. We're gonna have to run. Okay, okay, okay. Eh. Oh god, I missed, I missed. Oh, oh my god. Get up, Daniel, my god. Heart is in my throat. I hate this. Here's that. Yeah. Here's that. Okay. Oh god. Oh god. Eat. You're a hungry, hungry hippo. Okay. Can I get under that, you think? Oh, here we go. I'm gonna try it. Daniel. God love you. Okay. There we go. Oh god. It's locked with a simple lock. Maybe I probably should have shut that door. I don't know if the door's gonna stop. How do I get that damn door open? Oh, my heart is racing. Okay. Can I? No, you're not one I can open. Oh, there you are. Aren't you bored of me? Don't you want to go somewhere else? I don't have anything in my inventory. Maybe there's something on that shelf over there. Oh my god. I'm gonna have to do some editing. Otherwise, this entire video is just gonna be me standing around. Being a complete chicken shit. Okay. And then we have to go. We just have to go. But I don't want to go. God. Oh God, oh God, oh God. Is that something there? What is that? I think there is something over here. Okay. Oh God, the jump is so bad. Okay. Oh my God. Picked up a hollow needle. What am I gonna sew? What am I doing? I really wish I could do, like, injure it. Okay. Is there anything else? Am I really supposed to? Okay, I guess let's thread the needle, I guess. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Oh, yeah, I need to do this. Eh? Archive tunnels. Something large brushed against his leg, and he felt himself being dragged along by the current of the beast. He pushed himself above the surface. Help! He cried as the ocean swallowed him again. Oh, fantastic. Is that it? Are we done? Is it gone? Okay. That's cool. Nope. Back up, Dana. Okay. I think we're in the clear. Oh, awesome. What? No, we're not. No, we're not in the clear. Oh, my God. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God. Oh, my God. I don't know. I'm just running, man. I don't even care. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Go, 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 go. Oh, jeez. Oh. Oh, my God. Go. Daniel. Oh, God. Oh, God. Back hall. He felt himself being hoisted out of the ocean. The lacquered hull of the SS Hortensia glittered in the soothing warm yellow light of a setting sun. He turned his head to the calm ocean reaching towards the coast of Portugal and thought, is this another dream? Oh my God. Okay, hold on, give me a minute. Holy crap. Okay. I need to collect myself. That was intense. Holy crap, dude. Oh, like my stomach is in knots. I think the game wants us to go that way. And there seems to be a blood trail. Okay. Well, that fountain is positively Lovecraftian. Can I just stay here? We don't come across that thing again, do we? It looks like there's tracks in the floor. I feel like I should be able to maybe push these things. You see? Okay, maybe not. Okay. I was just checking. Maybe I did something I wasn't supposed to do and got damaged. Okay. You know what? F your jar. Let's take a look around and see what's what before, oh God, we decide Where to go next? It sure as shit not gonna be the archive tunnels. Okay, so we got a study. Guest room. That might be fun. Anything over here? Anything hiding? Hell yeah. Okay, so I've got... I still have that chemistry jar. Am I gonna need it again, or... Oh. No. Okay, I think I'm gonna, check out the guest room. Herbert's trunk was wrapped in rope. The lock had been broken by thieves, he assumed. He wondered if anything had been left, considering all the hands it had passed.
My journal is gone. What would they want with my journal?
So is this our room? Damn, dude, it looks pretty ransacked. Okay. More laudanum.
Second of July, 1839. I received a letter today from the Algerian governor's office disclosing the fate of Herbert's expedition. About a week after my departure, Abdullah, one of the men traveling with us, returned from the desert. He was badly injured, as if maimed by a lion. The man rambled deliriously about the expedition being attacked by something horrible. The French quickly dispatched a search party to look for the expedition. After searching for days, they found the camp abandoned without any trace of Herbert or his men. Tomorrow, I'll retrieve the things they recovered from Herbert's tent at the customs house. I don't know what to make of it, but I'm worried for him.
Okay. I've never been so happy to see and hear hissing cockroaches before in my life. Little bunny foo-foo hopping through the forest. Ooh. Get out of here. Okay.
Daniel.
What?
Still having nightmares, I see.
Yes. I can't shake them. They come every night.
We'll put a stop to them. You'll see.
That almost sounded threatening. Okay, so there's... I see that crowbar there. Still not over that chase.
3rd of July, 1839. Today I picked up Herbert's things at the customs house. I dug through the trove of documents he had carried and found a log detailing the expedition. The nature of this text ranged from quick notes to colorful accounts of transpired events. I skimmed the pages, trying to figure out what might have happened. May 17th, the day I was trapped inside the orb chamber, Herbert dryly states, recovered Daniel after 1 hour of entrapment. This confused me greatly. I was suffocating within minutes. How could I have lasted an hour? I continued reading the peculiar text. Herbert states his facts without judgment or passion, but suddenly I could read frustration into his text. He pushed his men to investigate the underground tomb, an effort which seems to have strained the minds of his men. Madness spread through the ranks, and Herbert had to take some extreme measures to continue. He finally visits the chamber himself, where he retrieves the orb to the surface. His account confuses me greatly. If he has the orb, what are those pieces in my drawing room?
Uh-oh. Okay, I'm not gonna pick that up just yet. I feel like if I pick it up, something's gonna happen. And I'm not ready for something to happen. The door's stuck due to a broken lock. God damn it. Another way to open the closet door in the guest room. Never mind. Come here. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Oh. There we go. Important key is hidden in the guest room. Okay. So we are now looking for a key. Oh, hey. This game is unbelievable. Go away. Might I recommend you head down to the archive tunnels, sir? Daniel just came out of the closet. Don't laugh at that. That was stupid, too. Okay, so we're looking for a key. Oh, boy. I'm, like, kind of, like, shaky. Not, like, from being scared, just, like, how tense I was.
Fourth of July, 1839. It's done. The orb is assembled. I was awakened by an exhausting nightmare. Shaking and sweating, I retired to the drawing room with a cup of tea. The relic pieces lay spread across the table as I'd left them, but somehow I knew how it was supposed to be. I fetched the tar, which I had prepared to fix the pieces together, and without fault, I joined them, producing the orb I remembered so clearly. The tar proved unnecessary. It was pushed out from the joining pieces as they merged on their own, with no adhesive. The ancient stone relic now rests on my table. Its immaculate surface and perfect shape could have been molded by a factory. This is all too strange.
Okay, but there's like two orbs. The one you kind of sort of pieced together, and then the one that Herbert has. Holy crap, seriously?
Oh, thank God, there it is. I guess it is a good place to hide it then.
I am a lucky girl. I just... They're just There. Machine room key. Oh god, this thing's gone, isn't it? Okay. I still have the surgical needle. I have no idea what I'm supposed to do. Okay. Whew. Game, I don't think I can take much more. But it's... But it's one of those things, like, I'm enjoying it. I feel like that's a little masochistic. Professor Taylor was the second death caused by his damned curiosity. Oh. Wait, was that there? I don't think that was there when it first came up. Is he in here? Okay, I don't think so. I think we would have heard it by now. Sir William Smith has been marked. There was no way for him to know that the young man from the other day cast such a terrible shadow. So the shadow is chasing us, and anybody we come across is gonna feel its wrath. Let's just, you know what? And... Yeah. No, it's just gonna pick up, okay. Oh, damn it, there's the dogs crying again. Is there anything else? Kind of low, monotonous humming in the background is going on again. Daniel, you're fine. Calm down, dude. Happy? Okay. This is a hell of a study. Like, it's an entire wing of the castle. A study is usually just one room. Making sure there's nothing on the shelves. Letter regarding the discovery of an orb to my most trusted student and friend, Johann Weyer. The most remarkable thing happened as I was traveling through the Prussian woods this summer. I finally found one of those orbs I've been looking for the last 20 odd years. It is as inexplicable as the Heliodormus described it in the Hortus Conclusus. It was as it was told about, an underground meteoric temple crowned with the unearthly artifact. The orb was big enough to fill my cupped hands, and the texture was smooth and jagged. Its color washed while rich. Contrast is not enough to describe its nature. It was an impossibility, an artificial paradox captured within the stone. I was staying in a nearby village called Alstadt, investigating one of the antiquated trails, when I finally found the cavern. I went inside, and suddenly I could verify the truth of these enigmatic artifacts. They were real. As you can understand, this is the most important discovery of my life, but it has also become my greatest fear. As I entered the underground chamber, I could feel that I was trespassing. Because of my curiosity, I did my best to fight these instincts and fetch the orb from its place. I scrambled out of the chamber and into the woods. I could sense something was following me. It bayed loudly as it closed in. The beast, this guardian of the orb, was relentless in its pursuit. I made my way to a nearby ravine, where I stumbled upon some men fishing in the lake. I tried to warn them as I passed, but fortunately, they remained as I continued my escape. When I heard their cry of pain echo through the valley, I felt such a tremendous sense of relief, thinking I would be spared. Suddenly, a blue shimmering light engulfed me, and the colors of the forest were washed away before my eyes. I kept running through the bleak surroundings. The trees had turned charcoal, black with leaves of cinder, the ground covered in murky water. I pressed on through the drenched land as the glowing ember gave way to the rising wind and rained on me. I could hear pleading screams in the distance, and I joined in as pain and fear overtook me. I fell to the ground, gasping for air. This certainly must sound strange, but I had been carried miles away across the Alps to a grassy field outside Genoa. The Guardian had taken the orb from me, but still, until this day, I fear its return. Sometimes I lay awake at night, listening for the howling cry I heard in the forest. It has been nearly a decade since that day, and I still haven't been able to write about the incident. The last time we spoke, you told me about your interest in ongoing research into the mythic orbs, and I realized I owed you the truth about my visit to Altstadt. Your friend and mentor, Heinrich Cornelius Agrippa. Huh. Okay. So, the shadow, the kind of fleshy stuff that's hunting us, is because we came in contact with the orb and apparently took it. Good job, Daniel. See, don't. Oh. Let's just close you.
Let's see what you have to offer.
Oh my God. You piece of shit. Oh.
But I can sense it. It's definitely there.
I am gonna kill you dead so many times. Oh, Alexander. Oh, honey, milestones of human anatomy. You, no. You done effed up. You hurt an animal, and more specifically, you hurt a dog. You're dead. You're dead, and I will burn you and everything in this damn castle down to the ground. That is incredibly upsetting. Can we not? Animal experiment, Canis lupus familiaris. After a short study, it is clear that the agitation found among humans can be found in the dog. Fear and pain induce stress, which seems to trigger an endogenous response, causing the animal to burst with energy. I believe that the catalyst is produced in the brain. It is difficult to determine exactly where and what it is, but I can sense it. It reeks of cosmic genesis. There is an inherent problem in harvesting this energy, since the creature is bound to die from the exercise. I must refine this process of torture to enable any real work to be done. More experiments must be performed, but it seems that only human beings are able to produce the amount necessary. It might be their ability to appreciate the severity of the process that ultimately augments their experience of terror. So he's torturing and killing things to get something from them. But having them die from the torture is apparently inconvenient. So he's saying he needs to find a way to prolong the process. Oh my God, please tell me we can kill him. Give me that, give me that. I'm sorry about that. Is this Alexander over here? On the wall, is that him? Is that his portrait? Anatomy Frontiers. Further disappointment. The antiquarian's latest findings yielded nothing. I'm still unable to grasp the inner workings of life and its relation to the power I sense within it. I shall pursue more books on the subject, but I suspect it will be in vain. Since no research has been made in my particular interest, I must attempt to fill that void myself. Clearly humans emanate more of the energy I seek, but I hope animals will suffice, as they would prove less of a hassle to acquire. Oh, you're gonna get it. You are gonna get it. And Daniel, what the hell, dude? Were you helping him? Oh. I can't. Oh. Find another way around the rubble in the study. I can't even feel sorry for Daniel anymore. I mean, not that I ever felt sorry for him, but. Okay, is there something like a hidden panel, something I can move? You know what? I'm gonna bring your book. How do you like that? Oh, okay, well, there, I showed him. Huh, is there maybe a way to get around this? No. I thought maybe. I don't know what I thought. I'm so mad. Jesus, you got anything to add? Okay. This might be something I need to come back to. Okay, I just walked right by that. The cracked window panes are held together only by weak wooden frame. Okay, I probably need to do something with that. What is? Oh, it's an eye! Ew, I picked up an eye! Gross! Ugh! Whoa! Okay. Okay, I feel like I probably, I don't know, maybe, oh, blood. Need to do something with that window. There's no other reason that it would give me that prompt. But let's go. The strange letter frightened him, but it was also the only one which offered some comfort. Before I start breaking windows, let's... Slight headache. Okay, what's this open when we first entered? So what's down here? I kind of don't want to go in. Because clearly that's where the game wants us to go, but if I go down there, am I going to be able to get back out, is the thing.
You have an ascending room. Will it take us to the inner sanctum?
It will definitely take care of the vertical part of our journey. So, you have ridden an elevator before?
Yes, the Colosseum at Regent's Park has one. It takes you to the gallery where you can view the panorama.
Good. This ride might be a little longer, and in the other direction.
Yeah, Alexander can eat a whole bag of dicks for all I care, and I hope he chokes on them. Okay, let's... What is this, a Labrador? Oh, machine room! And we have the machine room key. Okay, so... This is the direction we want to go in, that area, but let's go check out.
Don't forget your bag, Daniel.
I won't, Herbert.
There is no shame in using a parasol in the desert. As it happens, it's imperative to your survival.
But it looks ridiculous.
The shade will hurt much less than dying, I assure you.
Oh, that was a little... He patted him on the shoulder. Nice little sound effect. I don't know why that impressed me, but it did. Anyway, okay. Let's go down here. What's this? Storage. Oh, God. He flipped through the Book of Monarchs looking for etchings and counted. 9 different kings from all over Europe had been depicted with an orb resting in their hands. Oh. We just entered Fun Town, everyone. Okay. Oh, you know there's something down here with us. Here. The darkness in the storage feels strange and unnatural. Oh, God. That's foreboding. See you, I'm coming. Equipment. Okay. I'm just gonna light a few. I want to leave enough darkness. Should something come after me, I have decent cover to hide in. Are there any torches in here? Okay, you know what? Let's be smart, little British people. Ooh. Mm-hmm. Picked up drill part. Son of a bitch. Okay. Go about your business. Is it gone? I'm gonna assume once that music stops, you're in the clear. So are we supposed to assume, does Daniel suffer from nyctophobia, which is the fear of the dark? Or is it just something that comes from, maybe coming in contact with the orb or the living nightmare, as it's called? Please don't let there be anything down here that wants to kill me. Okay. Regarding explosive mixture, Alexander, I have prepared the explosives you needed for clearing the flood drain. I can't stress enough how important it is that the mixture is handled with care. Please try to tell your feather-brained servants this before you go ahead with your plans. The liquids are not by themselves explosive and should be kept separated to avoid further mishaps. I've arranged two large vats in the next room for the ingredients. All you need to do is to mix the liquids and you are ready to go, Agrippa. Okay. Oh, is that still why, am I supposed to collect the mixture in the chemistry jar? Is that why I still have it? Something. I feel like I'm getting a lot of items here. And I can't say that makes me super confident. There's something over here. You up in a minute and make sure there's nothing else. Just making a little hidey hole in case once I pick this thing up, something comes in here. You know? We're gonna do that. Although, now that I'm looking around, it looks a little too bright. They probably still see me, so. I mean. I guess we just have to go for it, don't we? Alright. I'm gonna reopen that just because I have to haul ass. Here we go. Some items can be combined in the inventory. Okay, so I gotta. A drill bit. Okay. Let's put this together, I guess. So, drag and drop one item onto another. Okay, so can't assemble the drill yet. Need to find all other parts first. Okay, well, it looks like there's a door over here. Is it? Okay. That's probably got the mixture in it. What am I putting a drill together for? Okay, is that the last piece? Let's go back to my little corner and put this together. Okay. There we go. Okay. Oh. Okay, it just put them all together for me. Thank you, game. Oh boy. Okay, so we have a hand drill. I'm not really sure what we're supposed to use that for. Okay. Let's head back up. Oh, look at all that stuff down there. Oh, I'm stuck. Okay. I think I'm gonna call it for the day. Am I? No, let's I'm at the point in the game where I'm like, no, keep going. Oh. Machine parts.
Please, let me go. I won't tell anyone, I swear. I just want to go home. No! Get away from me! Leave me alone!
That. Okay, yeah. Yeah, I'm at the part in the game where I'm just like, no, keep going. I got blood on the ground. Okay, let's... Let's do it. It won't budge. Rubble from a cave-in is hindering further passage in the storage. Find a way through. Is that what we need the explosives for? Okay. I think now I'm going to call it. Holy crap, this was an intense. You cannot use this item in this way. Well, sorry. I just thought I would give it a shot. Game's getting sassy. Okay, so yeah, that's we're gonna cut it here. We will pick back up. I need to go and figure out what I need to do to break that window in the study, figure out the drill thing, get some explosives, and continue on with my plan to kill Alexander. But that's what I have for you all today. Always feel free to leave a comment. I like hearing from you all. Leave a like, dislike, subscribe, share the video. It is always appreciated. And that's it. That is Amnesia for this Thursday. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I hope you all take care. And I will see you, I believe, Saturday. So toodles!